Vince, master of exaggeration.
Saturdays on Hang Time. Stay tuned for more TNBC.
Week on USWA Championship Wrestling.
And I'm sick and tired of your lies, Brian. Just admit the truth. You're jealous of Billy Joe. Admit it for once.
Has 100%. There's the super kick. It's Billy Joe Travis. He's got power. It sends power into the eyes of Brian Cutler. Spellbinder is out.
Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell with Michael St. John right along ringside as we are every Saturday. And we're looking forward to a major show today. Michael, I've been out for a couple of weeks and I'm delighted to be back. Boy, did a lot of things take place.
Boy, Lance, I tell you, I got to bring you up to date. And it's just getting further and further. The things are just going crazy in the USWA. The war, and that's the best thing you can call it, the war between the USWA and ECW has escalated into mammoth proportions.
Yeah.
Jerry the King Lawler, Brian Christopher, it's more than words now, and this is going to come to a head. The USWA Heavyweight Championship is in limbo, and I'll tell you why. Billy Travis, as you know, has had some problems. Well, as a result of the problems he's been having, he hasn't been showing up.
Hey, he just flat out no-showed someplace.
Exactly, and he will, as a result, have to defend his USWA Heavyweight Championship today on television. The
right
title
here
will be on the line, and his opponent will be one of five men, and we have five sealed envelopes. And we're going to have a member of our studio audience pick the opponent for Billy Travis for the USWA Championship.
And that challenger will be going against Billy right here on television today. I understand that Stephen Dunn was one of the names that's in there.
Paul Diamond.
Spellbinder, Paul Diamond.
Flash Flanagan, Brian Christopher.
Brian,
those are the five names in the envelope.
In here, one of them will be drawn. They will go for the title today on television.
And we don't know who it is. The audience don't know who it is. And mainly, Billy Travis doesn't know who it is. So he'll have a big test today for the USWA Championship on the line.
But I'm glad to say, and I want to add this right here, they're doing what they should do, because when the guy starts ducking Christopher and other guys like that and starts calling his own tune, then miss a shot. Do what they did. They demand the title be defended today.
And the USWA has been invaded by PG-13. Now, they say they're part of ECW. I'm not sure that they're part of anybody. But PG-13 has come back into town with a vengeance. We'll hear from them a little bit later on tape. They have they have really gone over the edge now, Lance,
I'll tell you.
And the biggest surprise for me last week here on Championship Wrestling is Spellbinder came out and a match in which Brian Christopher was in the ring, and I thought Spellbinder, you know, Brian Christopher and Spellbinder have been at war.
Never great friends, no.
Never. And I just knew that Spellbinder was just going to nail Brian from behind. Well, lo and behold, he gets in the ring. He cleans house on behalf of Brian Christopher to help him out, and then gets out here and shakes his hand and says, hey, I don't like you, but I respect you, and I'll be in your corner if you need me. So
wonders never cease.
It's amazing. Paul Diamond, as you said, will be here.
Yep.
Dutch Mantel's going to be here.
No, Michael.
And that's
he's going to be back out here
he's
again.
He's going to be back out here again. So that's where we stand, Lance. That's the best I can do to get you up to date, but we got a lot of action here today.
We have some great action here today, and we're just hoping that maybe you're going to enjoy it as much as we're going to enjoy bringing it to you, and the only way to do it, take time out right now and get ready for that opening bout that will be coming up in just a moment. We'll be back with Stephen Dunn in the ring in just a moment.
Hey, fans, stay tuned. This is Stephen Dunn. As you can tell, the battle lines have been drawn, and I'm ready for war. So, Bulldog, get ready, because I'm coming at you.
Every Saturday, Miss Parker's got it in for the Pretender.
She's so mean and nasty. Talking about Miss Parker, don't you know? Don't you know?
When is he?
Get him!
Golly, you're so dangerous! You're so mean and evil, girl!
Find him!
Oh, why you got to be so bad? Why you got to be that way, girl?
That's just the way I like it.
It's home cover-up time at Curlow Construction, and it's your chance to uncover big savings on the improvements your home needs. Right now, save up to $300 on Curlow's best 20-year asphalt fiberglass shingle roof. Save up to $800 on low-maintenance weather-beating siding. Call this number right now for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with 100% bank rate financing and no money down, Curlow has you covered. Take advantage of home cover-up specials from Curlow Construction, Memphis' number one home improvement company.
Inventories have reached their peak at your local Ford dealer, and there's only one person to save us now.
Okay, open it up.
It's time again for factory authorized clearance.
Hey guys, it's good to be back.
He's back, and he's clearing out the 97s and passing the savings on to you.
Well, that's my job.
Get financing as low as 2.9%. Cash back as high as $1,500 on some of the best-selling cars and trucks in America.
Wow, this is big!
So if you're looking to save a lot of cash,
then look for me!
You're in your local Ford dealer's factory authorized clearance.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
Buying car insurance can be confusing, but not at Bill Blake Insurance. They can answer all your questions, and you only make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
Title defense and a bunch of other things, and one thing we're going to find out is about the relationship between Jerry Lawler and Brian Christopher. Boy, we're going to try to get that settled today.
And has that ever been a hot issue all over the world? I mean, but we'll get an answer. We've been promised, the king has said, that he'll make a statement today and will reveal if there's a relationship between Brian and the king.
We'd settle for the relationship. Forget the father, son, whatever it is. We'd settle for
any
kind of
relationship. Let's get to the bottom of it. Oh, hold on, Lance. Hold on. Wait a minute, Lance. Where the Billy?
Oh yeah!
Billy
oh,
Travis.
Oh yeah! Let me tell you something. This is a conspiracy against Billy Joe. I've been out the worst week of my life, and you put me in a position to wrestle for my title today.
No. You're not getting these envelopes.
Where's the fairness in this country? Where's the fairness in this company? This is a travesty!
You have the opportunity today to end up. The USWA says you have to put that
Michael
title on the line.
John, do you know what happened to me? I was in jail 12 hours. I'm still in pain and suffering. I don't have to wrestle nobody for 30 days. 30 days!
The USWA said because you failed to make championship matches in some of the cities that you have to put the title on the line today in one of these five.
Back me against the wall or back me against the wall. That's when I get the
tell him, Michael, you called it.
Draw a name. That's what I'm doing. I won't offend it against anybody. I don't care who it is.
We'll draw a name.
Get him out of here.
Yeah, we got
that. Billy's rights, you know. I want the people to know that the champion and myself are very unhappy about this situation. We don't like what's happened to Billy. He's been slandered. I don't think there's ever been a champion who's been treated this unfairly.
Lance, we need to get to the match.
Yeah, I do. And I want you to know, Luther, we're a little embarrassed about the whole thing, too. Let's go to right now the ring and
we
Tony.
We are set to go with our opening action today on Championship Wrestling. One fall, the 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, wrestling out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, weighing 280 pounds, here is Bulldog Reigns. His opponent, wrestling out of Hendersonville, Tennessee, 237 pounds, please welcome Stephen Dunn. One fall, 10-minute time limit, third man in the ring is Downtown Bruno.
All right, Bulldog Reigns, impressive son of a gun. Stephen Dunn, here's a guy that's been all over it. What I'm talking about, he has had the titles, been in the singles, been in the tag. And speaking of tags, here's a gentleman right over here with us at the desk, Paul Diamond, his partner, and they are looking for some titles.
You betcha, Lance. It's great to be here with you guys. Just kind of keep an eye on Steven to make sure that, with those titles online, we're trying to make sure
everything's get that
going
camera
perfect,
out of here.
Taking no chances.
This is private business.
How he
now,
does
stop.
Out here.
I don't want to take away from it, Michael, but you were mentioning something about a story that, do you want to get into
that? I picked up a little thing out of the locker room last week that there was some words exchanged between you and Steve. Everything okay? I mean, I understand you guys had like a little argument.
You know, things get blown out of proportion, Michael. Nothing really to speak of. I would guess just difference in thinking, the difference of wrestling, difference of accomplishing the same thing.
Hey, get that camera,
you know, he's wrestled
face,
different
no,
parts of the country. I have my own way
here.
Of doing
Let's
things. We're kind of stubborn, and sometimes, you know, each wants to get his own way. There's no problem with it. We've talked it out, and our main goal is wearing that gold around our waist again.
Those tag team titles.
On,
well, you might have an opportunity today. You are one of five individuals that may get a shot at the gold of the USWA, the USWA Heavyweight Championship.
Well, that'd be great. You know, anytime you get any type of an opportunity to go for a championship, you want to make the most of it. I'm focused on getting a tag belt, and if this comes my way, that'd be great, too.
Hey, what is Luger Biggs doing over here? He's telling him to get the camera off of him. He's got a pad. He's taking notes of some kind.
Last week, Lance, Luther Biggs came to the ring when Spellbinder came in, when Doomsday came in. He was around here. He actually went up. He and both Reggie B. Fine were recruiting, actually, out here actively. And I know he's got Billy Joe Travis in his stable, and maybe he thinks that his bread and butter man, Billy Joe, the champion, may be on his way out or something.
You know, I hate it when announcers get in here and ignore the action in the ring, because Stephen Dunn just pulled a belly-to-back beauty on Bulldog Reigns, goes underneath, leapfrogs over, look at here, takes him down, one, two,
got him.
Got him, right?
Hey, tag belts are going to be ours real soon, Lance. Great to be here.
Okay, I hope it stays smooth and you guys don't have any arguments.
No problems. No problems at all.
Paul Diamond, we like the Canadian boy and love Stephen Dunn, and he just pulled off. Doesn't look like anything's wrong over there, Mike.
I'm glad to see that, Lance. We got to take a break. We'll be back for more action from the USWA right after this.
Good idea.
Gary, I hear you're going all out for this big announcement.
That's right. They want to make it Hollywood. They want to make it a circus. I'm bringing in stars from Hollywood for the big announcement today.
Another stalled car on the expressway. Traffic has backed up considerably.
Could you use a little paradise about now? Alabama's Robert Trent Jones Golf Trail, one of the top 10 trips in the world by Frequent Flyer magazine. Paula DePerna in the New York Times calls this some of the best public golf on earth. 18 championship courses. Just you, not a worry in the world. Call 800-949-4444. It's not heaven, but it's close.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts, used and rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
Right now is the best time of the summer to save on menswear. At S&K Summer Clearance Sale, you'll find thousands of handsome suits starting at $2 for $199.90. And during this once-a-year summer clearance, all summer silk sport coats and sportswear are 20 to 33% off S&K's already low prices. Summer's just heating up, and at S&K, prices are coming down.
I see.
So where are you going to buy your next suit?
Shop the grand opening of our new superstore at the Commons, across from Wolf Chase Galleria.
Dave Thomas is sending out his crew with Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
Let's go.
Yeah. So everyone can try them.
Excuse me, ladies. Have you tried Wendy's new pitas?
This is our classic Greek pita. And this is our garden ranch chicken pita.
I see you're having the pitas.
None to be afraid of there. Just bread pita, really. Yeah, unless you're afraid of goodness.
Can I try them all?
Right now?
It's a beautiful thing.
Wendy's four new fresh stuffed pitas. If you haven't tried them, you will.
Dave, we found a woman in Idaho.
Let's go.
Okay, we're going to be going up to Tony Friedman in just a moment. We have a handicap match coming up with Huge Doomsday facing a couple of guys in the ring, and we'll be looking forward to that one. We would also like to tell you that this this title match, USWA heavyweight title match, has been ordered for today, and that will be... Here comes a Spellbinder. Let me see what... what the Spellbinder has got on his mind at the moment.
Well, Lance, what I have on my mind is just simple. I hear you and Mike speaking about how I came out to help Brian last week.
Yes.
And all I wanted to say was I had a reason for doing that. You see, there's a lot of bad blood between Brian and I because of these scars I have, and yes, I am angry. But one thing I have for Brian is a lot of respect. And when I see an animal like Luther Biggs come out here and bring two idiots and jump on them, I just can't sit down and just relax and let that happen and have a clear conscience. Just like anybody else out here wouldn't let that happen. I'm not gonna let it happen. And I do. So I'm telling you this now, Brian. I said it last week, and I'm gonna say it again. If you need my help, just call me, I'll be there.
Okay, hey, I remind you, Spellbinder, your name is in these envelopes here. You may get your shot today. Let's go right now to Tony Friedman in the ring. Tony.
We're ready for our handicap match scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing already in the ring at a combined weight of 562 pounds, the team of the Texas Ranger and the Master Blaster. Their opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, accompanied by Luther Biggs. Weight unknown, wrestling out of the wastelands, here is the Massive Doomsday.
I gotta tell you, Lance, last week when Doomsday made his debut in the USWA, I was very impressed by the size and the ability of this athlete. Even though they announce his weight unknown, he goes at about 340 and stands at 6'9". And I'll tell you, this guy, I don't know who can step in the ring that can stop this big guy.
Well, a couple of big guys that are going against him in the handicap match. The Master Blaster, obviously the one in the mask at the moment. He charges in, and the Texas Ranger just got flattened on his back with 1 foot in the air. There's a choke slam coming down from Doomsday. He gets hammered, and he just shook it off, Michael, like that didn't even hit him.
You know, Luther Biggs, when he first came into the USWA, didn't think a lot of him. I think a lot of him now, but I'll say this for him. He went out and found this guy. I don't know where he found him, but my question to him last week was, could he wrestle? And boy, can he not only wrestle, he can handle himself in and out of the ring. And he's just so massive that nobody can take the man off his feet.
Well,
look at that. He's just overpowering.
I'm telling you, he hit him with that clothesline, that snap clothesline. Bam! Look at that. And the Texas Ranger's head just bouncing off that mat every time he goes down. Here comes the Master Blaster. I'm sure he didn't want to get back in there with him, but he felt he had to, and he is caught right as he comes through the rope. Pounded on, and there he is, Doomsday, who has been most impressive. And immediately when you see a guy this big and this capable, you say, who can stop somebody that big, Michael?
And I'll tell you, in this kind of match, Lance, it's not like tag team rules. He's wrestling both men in the ring at one time.
Right. Drops down hard on the Texas Ranger, and back comes the Master Blaster. He was going to do a little blasting, but he never got it underway. The foot caught him in the midsection. In the air, and the power bomb right down from Doomsday. Now, you look how big. We're sitting here looking at this guy do this, and these guys are 240, 235, 32. Count of one and two, and Bill Rush, the referee, counts three. Can you believe it?
I'll tell you, that's not the nature of the match to beat both men at once, but that's entirely what he did. He exactly did what he said he could do and beat two men, but he beat them at the same identical moment, and you don't see that very often. And I'll tell you, Luther Biggs, you've been seeing him take notes, and I know he's developing a stable. But this Doomsday is something else.
Boy, I guess he is. We'll be seeing more of him, and I'm sure Luther Biggs just popping out of his buttons right there with the success of him. You said PG-13 back with an attitude problem, huh?
They are back in the USWA. They're claiming to be part of ECW. They are back, they said, to one thing, and they're going to clean house in the USWA. I know they made some comments. They're not here today, but they made some comments on tape, and I think we ought to take a look at this to get more
like
of the feel
to hear
of these guys.
Yeah.
Man, you know what? Tomorrow afternoon, man, we got to go back to Memphis, Tennessee. Used to be the PG's town. Used to be the town where PG roamed. But no, 90 days ago, when we lost a loser leave town in Memphis, Tennessee, It seemed like everybody seemed to forget what happened to PG-13. None of you fans sent cards. None of you rednecks cared what happened to us. And nobody cared what happened to PG-13. Nobody in the promotion and none of you fans. But we're back, and we're back in the USWA. And I guess you can see by looking at us, we've made a few new friends. And we're back to get our rightful place. We're back to get our belts. We're back to be on top of the USWA. And we're bringing a whole lot of more friends with us. And you tell them about that main event,
yeah,
brother.
Right after we win those tag team titles, Jerry Lawler and Brian Christopher, yeah. Man, you ain't seen Extreme until you've seen the Sandman and Tommy Dreamer, because they're our friends. Yeah. And they've been telling us just how mad they are at y'all. And what they're going to do is get real extreme right there at the big one tomorrow. Don't you miss it.
Well, there it is, Lance.
Yeah, boy, let's take a break. We'll be back with action still to come in just a moment.
Work it hard, man. The champion, Billy. Come on, baby. Work it out. Let's go. Big match coming up. We're going to show the people what it's like to be a champion. The people's champion. The USWA champion, Billy. Come on, man. Work hard. Work hard. There you go.
It's back. It's bigger than ever. It's factory authorized. Clarence?
Hi, everybody. Did you miss me?
You betcha, Clarence, because it's time to clear out the 97s, and your local Ford dealer is passing on the savings to you.
Hey, that's what I do best.
Get $1,500 cash back on Ford Taurus, or get $1,000 cash back or 2-9 financing on Escort.
Wow, that's huge.
So if you're looking to save a lot of cash,
then look for me, Clarence.
It's Ford's factory authorized Clarence at your local Ford dealer.
For those who go the distance, the start is critical. That's why Exxon Superflow races to protect vital engine parts at the start when significant damage can occur. Superflow has a unique formula offering protection that's fast, protection that lasts.
The big news at Sonic this summer? We've got all kinds of new drinks and desserts. And some new deals, too. We've got 5 everyday combo meals now. There's something for everyone. Extra long cheese conies, made-to-order burgers, chicken sandwiches, and they all come with fries and a medium Coke. Great deals on great food, and we don't charge extra for the fun.
When you go to get a new muffler, some places treat you like a dog.
First, you gotta perform tricks to even get them to work on it.
Then they make you roll over and play dead while you wait for them to finish.
And when the bill comes, you better beg for mercy.
Not at Meineke. At Meineke, you'll always get a high-quality muffler and professional, no-nonsense service fast.
In fact, you may want to shake their hand.
Good boy, Rusty.
At Meineke, you're not gonna pay a lot, but you'll get a lot.
I guarantee it.
I've got $50, $55, $60, $80, $90, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95, $95,
He waits. No, he ignores the phone. Who could it be?
Call return from Bell Cell. Just 75 cents per use.
The last number that called your line.
Solve the mystery with Star 69. Bell Cell. It's all here.
Dave Thomas is sending out his crew with Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Hi. Great day, huh? Nice board. Say, have you tried our new pitas?
They look great.
Yeah, just a whole bite full of delight there.
Fresh.
They are very fresh. Well, what else would you expect from Wendy's, huh? Easy to eat. You just pull back the wrapper and enjoy. Yeah, I used to surf quite a bit.
Wendy's four new fresh stuffed pitas. If you haven't tried them, you will.
Beautiful day. Beautiful day for a pita. Well, I gotta go. You enjoy that.
This portion of USWA Championship Wrestling is brought to you by Bill Blake Auto Insurance.
Still have a USWA heavyweight title match coming up today. Billy Travis been ordered to defend his title, and we've got five envelopes. Somebody from the audience will be picking it. We'll have that in a moment. Hey, we got the man, Tony Friedman, right here with the out-of-town action for USWA.
Thanks a lot, Lance Russell. Going to talk to you about all the action coming up here in the coming weeks in the USWA wrestling. Want to tell you about tomorrow afternoon, Caruthersville, Missouri. Something very special going to be happening. The invasion of Caruthersville begins tomorrow at 1:30 at the American Legion Field. The Lawler's Army softball team takes on the Caruthersville All-Stars. Understand we have a couple of the Caruthersville All-Stars here in the studio today, along with the coach of that team. All the proceeds from this event, it's a fundraiser to renovate the Pemiscot Hospital Pediatric Hall, and it's a softball doubleheader this Sunday, tomorrow afternoon, 1:30 p.m. at the American Legion Field in Caruthersville, Missouri. Lawler's Army takes on the Caruthersville All-Stars. Make sure you hit that one tomorrow at Caruthersville. Then from there, we're going to be back in Lula, Mississippi, Wednesday night, July the 16th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino. And Lance, we talk about the Lady Luck every week. All the action and excitement hits the Lady Luck Casino every Wednesday night. It's going to be another great one.
Boy, and some of the matches, they have some great stuff there, Tony. Looking forward to that on Wednesday.
Indeed we are. Then Caruthersville, Missouri, once again on Thursday night, July the 17th, 7:30 p.m., live USWA wrestling action returns to Caruthersville. Had the opportunity to be down there last time. Looking forward to coming back this coming Thursday night, July the 17th, 7:30 p.m., Doomsday, PG-13, and the superstars of the USWA face off and a free autograph session. Free color pictures of the king to the first 100 people in the door. Great value for the entire family at Casino Astar Thursday night, July the 17th. Then from there, we make our way to Huntington, Tennessee, Friday night, July the 18th. This Friday night, 8 p.m. at the Civic Center. Hot USWA Travis action. Also, Billy Travis audition and a 10-man battle royal for this Friday night in Huntington. Make sure you're out there for that one. Then we're going to be... We were supposed to be at the Bluff City Autoplex today. That one's been held off for 1 week. We're going to be there next Saturday afternoon, July 19th, 12:30 p.m. The USWA goes in overdrive when the king hits the ring next Saturday afternoon right here in Memphis, July the 19th, 12:30 p.m. at Bluff City Autoplex. Then we're going to make our way to Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday night, July the 25th, 8 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. Doomsday, Spellbinder, Billy Travis, Friday night, July the 25th, 8 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. Then from there, Jonesboro, Arkansas, Saturday night, July the 26th, 8 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. King Cobra, PG Walker now, Bulldog Reigns, plus many more, Saturday, July 26th in Jonesboro. That's the USWA on tour. Speaking of the action, Lance, we have big action coming up tomorrow night, Memphis, Tennessee at the Big One Expo Center. Fill us in on all the details.
You're right about that.
And I'll tell you, tomorrow, there has not been a card like this in the Bluff City here in Memphis, Tennessee, I bet in the past 6 or 7 years. It is the to end it all, the ECW versus the USWA. It has been talked about worldwide, not only here in the Mid-South, but the talk about this one has been worldwide for weeks now. And it all happens tomorrow night here at the Big One, starting at 7:30.
7:30,
and
that's important.
Main event, Jerry the King Lawler and Brian Christopher from USWA will defend the honor of the USWA against ECW's Tommy Dreamer. And I don't like that guy. I don't know about you, but I don't like that guy. And the Sandman, and that will be the big match. That tells it all. And that war will come to a head tomorrow night at 7:30 at the Big One.
Oh, boy, you know, and the thing that kicks me about this ECW thing, they talk like they're the only ones that were ever heard of the word tough, you know? Jerry Lawler has been in more tough battles than these guys have even dreamed about. And when he gets together with Brian Christopher and they meet those two guys, Dreamer and Sandman, hello, what a battle that one is going to be. That's not all of it, Michael. How about the semifinal match, which is going to be that Battle Royal?
The Battle of Memphis Stampede Royal Rumble. 16 men will end up in the ring. What it does is it starts out with two men. They start out in the ring, and then every minute, every 60 seconds, a new wrestler enters the ring. And by the time you get 16 men on there, you don't know who's fighting who.
Hey, I would have said just what you said, except I can't remember that kind of stuff. The only thing I remember about it is, before it's all over with, you are going to have a ring full of folks battling in there, and it's go from the word go. And they keep adding guys, and I love that concept.
And a big purse. They're all fighting for that money, and for the title of the king of the Battle of the Ring. And that's going to be one whale of a match. Plus, the USWA tag team titles will be on the line as the result of an edict by the USWA in that match. They are being billed as ECW's JC Ice and Wolfie D, PG-13. I don't think they're part of ECW. I think they're part of themselves. But they'll be in the match against Flash Flanagan and Nick Densmore. One of those teams is going to walk out with the USWA tag belt.
Got to tell you, the best thing that could happen to PG-13 is not to be claimed by ECW. Who wants to be complained by Extreme? Yeah. Hey, listen. Hardcore Showdown. Now, here's one that we're interested in. We can sit back and watch these guys get it on when we're talking about Mr. Monday Night Rob Van Dam. And let me tell you, this guy is talented. And Sabu, another talented one, going against Chris Candido. And that wild Tasmanian one, Taz, will be in here.
And it'll be crazy. These guys will stop at nothing. You know, they're wild men. That's the way to build that match. It's the hardcore showdown in that one. Plus a survival match, best 2 out of 3 falls. No time limit, no disqualification. There must be a winner. The loser is going to receive 10 lashes. And you know the bitter blood between this goes well beyond the wrestling ring. Brian Christopher against Billy Joe Travis.
Man, I can remember Brian Christopher standing right out there on the studio floor getting waylaid and bammed with that guitar over his head. He has got much, much more, as you said, Michael, to get settled. Bad blood match. How about Doomsday and Spellbinder? Couple of major men going in against each other.
And that's a battle of the giants, Lance. Plus on the card tomorrow night at the big one, Paul Diamond will take on Bulldog Reigns. Steve Dunn against P.G. Walker. He was P.J. Walker, but now he's P.G. Walker. And this whole lineup comes to a showdown tomorrow night at the big one here in Memphis. Bell time is at 7:30.
Yeah, we've said it, you know, and you think back and you say, boy, we got a big match coming out at the big one in there and all that. Hey, let me tell you, if you don't recognize it, there's nothing we can say anymore. This is a super big one taking place right out there at the big one tomorrow night. 7:30 is the bell time. Don't wait. One of the names that was mentioned, of course, in that big battle with Jerry the King Lawler and Brian Christopher was Tommy Dreamer. All I have is a picture of Tommy Dreamer. These guys, though, stands up there blah, blah, pouring the beer down and all that stuff. Let's hear what he's got to say about it.
Hello, Lance Russell, and hello to all of the wrestling fans watching us in Memphis, Tennessee. I'm Joey Styles, the voice of Extreme Championship Wrestling. I'm a big Lance Russell fan. I'm a bigger fan of professional wrestling, and that's why I'm thrilled about what's going down tomorrow night. Issues being settled in the ring where they should be settled, not in courtrooms, not with ratings wars, in the ring. Tomorrow night, Mr. Monday Night Rob Van Dam and Sabu, Jerry Lawler's favorite extreme tag team, will take on ECW's combination of the ECW World Television Champion, the Human Suplex Machine, Taz, and Mr. No Gimmicks Needed, Chris Candido, plus the King himself and Brian Christopher will take on the extreme icon, the Sandman, and my guest at this time, the innovator of violence himself, Tommy Dreamer.
Joey, how many years has Jerry Lawler been in WWF?
3, 4, who cares?
Never once did you say, I'm Jerry Lawler, and I represent the USWA. Joey, how many times has Brian Christopher wrestled on Monday Night Raw?
I think 3.
And every time he says he's from USWA. Brian Christopher, I have a little respect for you. At least you fight for what you believe in. And I don't blame you for never acknowledging that Jerry Lawler, the scumbag, is your dad. You see, Jerry Lawler, last time I saw you, you left me laying. You brought me to the hospital. When I came to Memphis, I left you laying. You sent the whole locker room out right before I was going to take you out. And I couldn't get the job done. But now, I'm gonna get the job done. Tomorrow night, I'm bringing the Sandman. I'm bringing ECW to the hardcore city of Memphis. And it's gonna be the way it was. Wrestling, fighting, a brawl. Everything you've always wanted in one night. Jerry Lawler, I'm taking you out.
Oh, the gauntlet's been thrown down, Lance.
Yes, sir. Tommy Dreamer, I said Sandman, and we've got something, some words about Sandman and Joey Styles. Good to see him. Joey's an excellent announcer. The only thing is, I question is the people that he's hanging out with up there sometimes. I don't know whether Joey is with this one or not, but I know Tommy Dreamer, Sandman rather, is right there. So let's take a listen, Michael, and see what that has to say.
Tommy Dreamer and the Sandman going to Memphis to visit USWA. Jerry Lawler and your brat. You guys want to have a little party? ECW knows how to party. I'll show you how. You want to get extreme? I'll show you how. Tomorrow night.
Whoa.
Hey. I mean, that's crazy. That's crazy. Don't worry about doing it too much to the Sandman right there, your own self. Jerry Lawler and Brian Christopher has some ideas about taking care of a little of that, huh?
And here they come now. I think we're going to hear what this is going to be all about tomorrow night at the big one.
Well, we've been talking about them. Dreamer and Sandman were talking about them. Why don't we let them speak for themselves? They're perfectly capable of doing that with their mouth and with their fist in the ring. We're talking about Brian Christopher, Jerry the King Lawler. Tomorrow night is going to be the showdown. It'll be Brian and Jerry against Dreamer and the Sandman, and that is one we just flat don't want to miss. What do you think? Here it comes in here. Well, you've heard it all. It's been said. Brian.
Lance, what a night it's going to be. What a night it's going to be tomorrow night at the big one. Nobody wants to miss it, because this is a night that people are going to be talking about for months and possibly years, because this is the first time that the ECW has invaded Memphis, Tennessee, and I'm just glad, I'm just tickled to death to be a part of it, Lance. But first, and I just hope that those ECW fans come on down there to the big one so we can show you just how we can get extreme and hardcore right here in the USWA. But first, Lance, I'm going to be wrestling not only in that match, but first, what I've been waiting on for a long time is this match with Billy Joe Travis. It's a match 2 out of 3 falls, right?
Right.
With the USWA heavyweight title on the line, the loser of the match has to be strapped to the turnbuckle, and the winner of the match gets to get a nice belt and give the loser 10 lashes across the back. Now, Billy Joe Travis, I brought this belt out here just to show you what I was going to have in my hand. Yeah. But this isn't the one I'm going to use, Travis. I want somebody out there to come down to the big one, and I want you to bring me the biggest, the thickest leather strap you can find, because that's what I'm going to use on you, Travis. After I beat you like a dog, it's going to be worse than anything you ever seen on Roots, Lance. I'm going to beat him until the blood is running down your back. Then, that's when it's time to get extreme. That's when it's time to get hardcore. That's when I'm going to step in the ring with this man right here as my partner, and Sandman, Tommy Dreamer. It all starts at 7:30, but it ain't going to end until we're through beating you over the head with everything we can get our hands on.
Oh, boy, you think that one isn't going to be something? Wait till you get around to seeing Brian and Jerry together against Sandman and Dreamer.
Sandman and Dreamer, let's talk about them, Lance. Let's talk about the ECW for just a minute.
Please do.
First of all, I heard you compliment Joey Styles. You said Joey Styles is a great announcer. Let me tell you something, Lance.
I didn't say great.
Yeah, you did.
Excellent.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you something. There is nothing excellent at ECW, I can assure you. I've been there.
I've seen it.
There's nothing excellent about it. That includes Joey Styles. He couldn't say grits with a mouthful, and you think he's an announcer? Well, he's not. But I want to tell you something, Joey Styles. I want to give you a personal invitation. I want you to come on down to Memphis. Come on with the rest of the extremely crappy wrestlers from up there and see what it's like down here. Now, Sandman, we all know what you're all about. You are, and I'm just going to lay it right on the line right now. I'm going to tell everybody exactly what Sandman is all about. Sandman is quite simply a drunk drug addict. Do you know what I'm talking about, Lance?
Yeah! Yeah!
The reason Sandman is in ECW is because WCW, WWF, or USWA wouldn't book him on a dare because he's a drunk drug addict. He has to get drunk to get up enough courage to go in the ring. Have you seen him, Lance? Does he take a six-pack to the ring with him?
Yes, he does.
Does he drink beer during the match? He's obviously a drunk drug addict. And Sandman, you better bring some more friends because Tommy Dreamer ain't going to get the job done from you. You better bring Jack Daniels, and you better bring Jim Beam, and you better drink them down big time, brother. You better be so drunk when you stagger into that ring, because if you're not, you're going to feel some extreme pain like you've never felt in your life. Now, Tommy Dreamer, let's talk for a minute about Tommy Dreamer. Tommy Dreamer, you like to come out here and stand all nice and calm and act like you know what you're talking about. And you did say one thing that was true on your little interview. You said, Jerry Lawler, the last time I saw you, you left me laying. And that's right, Tommy Dreamer. I came to ECW, and I took that stick away from the Sandman, and I hit Tommy Dreamer. You saw it last week. I hit him right between the legs with Sandman's stick. And you know what I heard, Lance? I heard they had to haul Tommy Dreamer to the hospital. And I heard that they had to do, this is what I heard now, this is the word that ECW put out. I heard that they had to do a little surgery on Tommy Dreamer's testicles. Hey, but you know what? You know what, Lance? I'm gonna tell you something right now. I know that's a lie. I know that's not true, because Tommy Dreamer, I'm here to tell you, you don't have any testicles, pal.
Come on now. Well, I hope this is settled tomorrow night.
I'm going to tell you something. Tomorrow night, Tommy Dreamer, when I get through with you, you're going to have to go to the hospital, but what you're going to have to go see is a gynecologist, and I promise you that. It's going to be extreme tomorrow night at the big one, and I mean what I'm talking about.
Boy, I don't have any doubt about that. You can see how out of hand this thing has gotten, Michael. Well, we'll take time out. We got more great action still to go. Did you ever hear anything like that?
Lawler, I want to see what you got to say about that. Brian Lawler, is he your son? I'm going to be listening real close because I got something to say about it myself.
When you go to get a new muffler, some places treat you like a dog. First, you gotta perform tricks to even get them to work on it. Then they make you roll over and play dead while you wait for them to finish. And when the bill comes, you better beg for mercy. Not at Meineke. At Meineke, you'll always get a high-quality muffler and professional, no-nonsense service fast. In fact, you may want to shake their hand.
Good boy, Rusty.
At Meineke, you're not gonna pay a lot, but you'll get a lot.
I guarantee it.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
I've been doing business with Bill Blake Insurance for years. He's always there when you need him, and you only have to make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
$2,000 off on every new Neon Breeze and Cirrus at Covey & Bike Chrysler. When you hear them say, nobody beats our prices, I'm the nobody they're talking about.
$2,000 off every new Neon?
$2,000 off on every new Neon.
Every new Breeze?
$2,000 off on every new Breeze.
Every new Cirrus?
You heard me, $2,000 off on every new Neon Breeze and Cirrus at Covey & Bike Chrysler.
Ooh, what about the hat?
Touch the hat.
Covey &
Bike,
Chrysler,
Covey & Bike,
Covey & Bike, Memphis.
Is it home improvement time at your place? If so, turn to the Mid-South's home improvement leaders, Curlo Construction. Let the professionals at Curlo cover your home with beautiful, easy maintenance siding. Next, let's install energy-efficient tilt sash replacement windows. They're easy to clean and beautiful. Call this number for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with no money down and 100% bank rate financing, now's the time to call Curlo Construction. At Curlo, we're improving Memphis, one home at a time.
We're back on the USWA, ready for another exciting match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing already in the ring, wrestling out of the Bronx, New York, weighing 231 pounds, here is P.G. Walker. His opponent, wrestling out of Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing 229 pounds, please welcome Flash Flanagan. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Flash and PG getting ready to get it on. PG says, come get me. He didn't have to wait too long because Flash was there.
I guess the name change is complete. PJ Walker has now become PG Walker at the insistence of JC Ice and Wolfie D of PG 13. So I wonder if there's some kind of alliance being formed here.
I don't know, but whoa, look at Flash. Comes right up on his feet as he goes around for the hip. Beautiful move, Walker.
I'm a drop.
Flanagan, huh? One, two. Couldn't get him for the third.
Peachy Walker has made a quite impressive debut in the USWA over the past few weeks, and we know Flash Flanagan is one of the fine young stars in the USWA. This is quite a match to be here on television, and both of these men trying to rise to prominence for that number one contender position for the USA Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah, Walker I'm not familiar with at all. I am impressed with what I've seen of him thus far. Flanagan hanging on, one, two, and out of it, he kicks it. These guys are going after it hard.
P.G. Walker is out of the Bronx, New York. Actually was a gang man. Well, I won't say a gang man, but a tagger, if you would. One of these guys that spray painted. In fact, takes credit for actually getting up on the Brooklyn Bridge and spray painting it. But he has been quite impressive in the USWA. He has a maneuver he will use in the ring to beat his opponent called the 187, which is a police call of some sort. And we can see right now, he's taking command of this match right now against Flash Flanagan. And Flash needs to come out of there. He's in a tough situation right now.
Pure slam followed by Walker going up the ladder to the top rope. Comes flying down. Bango! Nails him in the head. But Flash still got a lot of get up and go as he hammers his way out of it. Comes up swinging and Walker goes to the eyes as he jawjacked him with that head right underneath the jaw. And Flash in some trouble. We're not used to seeing this young man in this kind of trouble. This Walker gets around and gets there in a hurry.
He is quite impressive. You know, Lance, I hate to take anything away from this match, but I'm sort of anxiously anticipating what the King has in store. We finally get an answer, hopefully, today on TV on this Jerry Lawler-Brian Christopher relationship thing. And I'm a little anxious, a little anticipatory as to what's going to come off.
Hey, I like that, too. Okay, the leg hook, one, and two came down, but that's all. As referee Downtown Bruno had no call to bring the third one down as Flash had kicked his way out of it. Look at P.G. Walker going hard on Flash Flanagan. If you stopped it right now and settled it on a point system, which we don't, it would be P.G. Walker who, oh boy.
I think he just lost some points, Lance.
Yeah, I think that may have just evened the situation up, Michael.
There we go. Here comes Flash Flanagan climbing up to the top ropes. Uh-oh, a little repay there.
Yeah.
A little payback by P.G. Walker. These two guys have gone at it tooth and nail in this match. Walker now climbing the ropes. He's got Flash set up off that second strand of rope. Oh, suplex off the second strand.
This look at here. He's got him hooked down, and that's a low one. He's got a 1, 2, 3. Beautiful maneuver from Flash Flanagan. Excellent move. He won everything but the match. P.G. Walker did. And Flash Flanagan used what is a little bit more experience to get him and grabbed him up really tight and held him for the 1, 2, 3, Michael.
I'll tell you, that was a sudden turn of events that caught him in that small package, and Walker not very happy about that.
No, he isn't. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing him at a future date, because anytime you see good young talent that can go like that, even if they are sometimes shading the rules, and it looks to me like that there may be a PG in our future.
Well, I think Dutch Mantel has some comments for us too, Lance, at this point. I think he's standing.
You know, Jerry Law, let me tell you something. For weeks and weeks and weeks, people have been waiting for the answer. Is Brian Christopher your kid, or is you Brian Christopher's dad? What is the deal? because I don't blame either one of you. If you were my dad, I wouldn't claim you. And if he was my son, I wouldn't claim him either. But you either need to say yay or you need to say nay. And I'm going to be listening real close to what you say today, because if you don't, because I know the truth, next week, I'm going to tell everybody the truth right here on USWA Championship Wrestling, because everybody knows the icon tells the truth.
Michael St. John back with you, wrestling fans. This is the moment you've all been waiting for. It has been promised. Jerry the King Lawler is going to come out here right now and make the question. He's going to answer the question that has been burning on everybody's mind throughout the world of professional wrestling for weeks now. Brian Christopher. Is Brian Christopher the son of Jerry the King Lawler? Can we get the King out here? And let's find out right here and right now, once and for all, the answer to the burning question, the question that's permeated the world of professional wrestling for weeks now. You saw it on Raw. It was addressed on national television. The ECW has made a big deal about it. And now, right now, in the USWA, we're going to have an answer to the burning question. Is Jerry the King Lawler the father of Brian Christopher? So can we get the King out here? We're waiting for the King. And the fans are in anxious anticipation. They want the King out here, and here he is, making his way as promised. Jerry the King Lawler is out here to answer the burning question on the minds and in the hearts of wrestling fans throughout the world. And I gotta say, I'm very proud of Jerry the King Lawler, a man of his word, coming out here once and for all. We're gonna ask you the question, King, once and for all. You're gonna answer, I understand the question. Is Brian Christopher your son?
That's the question, is Brian Christopher my son?
That is correct.
All right, here's what. Everybody's trying to make this a big deal. Everywhere I go, whether it's the WWF or USWA, all of a sudden everybody wants to know, is Brian Christopher related to me? Well, I'll tell you what, I just decided to let's go ahead and make a circus out of this thing like everybody wants to do, okay? So for this big announcement, I've spared no expense. I've brought in my friend, the famous Hollywood Rip Taylor, all the way from Hollywood to help with this big announcement. Hit this music. Give Rip some music. Come on, here we go.
Oh, it is Rip Taylor, the comedian.
That's right. Let's make a circus out of this thing.
I swear I go right.
Holy. Well, I got to tell you, you brought in the man with the confetti and the craziness, Rip Taylor, here with us today on Championship Wrestling.
Oh, I'll tell you, we might as well make a big circus out of this. That's what everybody seems to want to do. Rip, my man.
Hey, oh, how are you? Oh, here's the King.
The man.
How are you?
Fine, Rip. Good seeing you. Welcome to the show. And for the King's big announcement, everybody wanting to know, is Brian Christopher the son of Jerry the King Lawler?
I couldn't hear you. The people were so happy to see me.
Well, the question that the King is going to answer here today on TV is Brian Christopher, the very popular wrestler, the very super wrestler in the USWA, the son of Jerry the King Lawler.
Don't they know that you didn't tell them?
I haven't told them yet.
Wait a minute.
And there you are. That's it. He told you, and thank you. That's the last time you're going to have to ask him. You heard what he said now. You heard what he said, okay? He'll never say it again.
Tell him to quit bothering me, too.
Now, don't bother him anymore. That's the last. You've heard him answer the question. Don't put him against the wall.
Okay?
Thank you very much.
I think we were off the air.
I can't help that. He answered your question. I have the show to do. Goodbye.
Back to Hollywood, Rip.
Wait a minute. We had a power block. King, Rip, there was a power blackout. Jerry, the fans don't know. Oh, my goodness. Let's go to a break, fans.
It's going to be me, guys. They're going to pick me, I'm telling you. Oh, yeah, it's going to be me. I'm going to beat him right here.
Has your wallet seen better days? If so, make tracks to Southland Greyhound Park for a free wallet filled with valuable coupons and a chance to win your share of $5,000 in cash vouchers. The wallet giveaway happens Saturday afternoon, July 19th at 12 noon. It's free wallets, valuable coupons, and $5,000 in cash prizes. And it all happens at Southland Greyhound Park, Saturday afternoon, July 19th. And remember, Southland is open year-round with free general admission and free parking always.
Dennis Hall's Auto Salvage, home of a million parts. Call or come by 3100 Gill Road and see Dennis Hall's large inventory of both domestic and foreign parts. Bumper-to-bumper body parts, used and rebuilt engines and transmissions. They also specialize in both new and used glass replacement for all makes and models of cars and trucks. For steering column and theft repair, Dennis Hall's guarantees the lowest prices in Memphis.
Hi, I'm Dennis Hall. For the best prices in town, come on down.
Wake up, Marvin. Relax. It's only me. Shame on you. For good things come to those who wait. For my soft buns, my beef, and my steamy onions come together in sweet harmony. They're still talking about the way you peeled out of the parking lot. Listen to the crystal.
Inventories have reached their peak at your local Ford dealer, and there's only one person to save us now.
Okay, open it up.
It's time again for factory authorized clearance.
Hey, guys, it's good to be back.
He's back, and he's clearing out the 97s and passing the savings on to you.
Well, that's my job.
Get financing as low as 2.9%. Cash back as high as $1,500 on some of the best-selling cars and trucks in America.
Wow, this is big.
So if you're looking to save a lot of cash,
then look for me.
During your local Ford dealer's factory authorized clearance.
What was said,
Lance,
Michael?
I gotta confess, when we went off the air, they were yelling at me in my earpiece from the control room that we were off the air, and I didn't even hear what was said because I was trying to find out what the problem was, and as a result, I missed the whole thing, and the fans...
So you don't have the answer.
Everybody missed the whole thing.
Wait. I know. All right. Hey, it's time to find out who the challenger for the USWA heavyweight title is going to be.
And Lance, I've got a young lady out of the audience here. Can we bring her over right
just
now? Let's see. I think I'm caught up here.
Coincidentally. Wait a minute. Let me get this.
There we go. Okay. I've got this young lady, if we can get her to come over here. And what's your name, young lady?
Carly.
Carly, and where are you from?
Florida.
You know this man sitting behind the desk there?
Yes, sir.
Who is that man?
He's my grandfather.
Yeah, this is one of my granddaughters here. And
now, wait a minute. Let's get
there's my son and to his, what would be camera left is
let's
the
let's get Billy out of here.
Sister.
Wait a minute.
Okay, hey, come on. Hey, come on, Billy. Don't start that.
I don't care who it is.
You get to pick the challenger for Billy Travis. Let him rant and rave, but you get to pick the challenger. Pick an envelope there. All right, there's the envelope. Open it up for us. And here's the big announcement. This is the challenger for Billy Travis.
Right.
For the USWA Championship right now, Lance.
Yeah,
let's just rip it open.
Carly,
here.
Go ahead and rip that. Yeah,
there you go. And here we go. Carly, let's open it up. And let's show it. Ah, here it is. It's the Spellbinder. Billy Travis takes on the Spellbinder for the USWA Championship right now in the ring. Carly, thanks for joining us. Sorry about Billy Joe Travis. Lance, let's go to the ring.
Okay, Tony Friedman.
All right, thanks a lot, Michael. We're ready to go with this very special attraction today on USWA Championship Wrestling. Introducing first, wrestling out of Dallas, Texas, weighing 234 pounds, the USWA Heavyweight Champion, the Sweet Music Man. Here is Billy Joe Travis. His opponent, wrestling out of Fantasy Island, weighing 282 pounds, the Spellbinder. One fall down to Lance Russell and Michael St. John.
Okay, the five guys were over there whose names are in these envelopes. And the belt is here. We'll get it collected and brought over here. In the ring is the Spellbinder, who will be challenging Travis. And on the outside, I see everybody but Brian Christopher. He kind of turned around and left that group, I noticed, when the Spellbinder was picked as the one to go against Travis. Anyhow, here we are, into the title match. Spellbinder presses him straight up in the air and then takes him off his feet, Michael.
Well, there was one of five envelopes that could have been picked. Spellbinder was the lucky one over Paul Diamond, Steve Dunn, Flash Flanagan, and Brian Christopher, and right now Spellbinder taking the measure of Billy Joe Travis. I tell you, Travis with his work cut out for him, And Billy Joe did not want to defend this title to begin with on television. This is a TV time limit match, yeah. One fall with a 15-minute time limit.
I'm glad you made that clear, that we do have the special stipulation that it is the TV time limit. As Travis back in the ring, Spellbinder, who certainly has the physical edge on Travis. Travis with more experience, and he is a dandy, an athlete himself, but his mind is just flat. I don't know, a guitar string got wrapped around his thinking process or something, because he has really gone off the deep end. Billy Joe whipped into the rope, and once again, Spellbinder presses him straight up over his head and hammers him down to the mat.
Well, almost a little bit of a lumberjack match right there as Flash Lanigan pushed Billy right up.
He's just helping him, Luther, that's all. He was helping him.
And Spellbinder taking the measure of Billy Joe Travis. One thing I want to point out, Lance, if you've noticed, ever since he has become a prodigy of Luther Biggs, there has been nothing but trouble for Billy Joe Travis. Yes, he won the title, but he was on his way to doing that before he ever linked up with Biggs. But he won the title, and then after that, it's all gone downhill for Mr. Travis, and it's continuing to go with the nature of this match in the ring right now.
Good point, and I don't think Luther wants anybody to hear those kind of comments, but it is absolutely true, and Billy Joe back up out of the corner after the Spellbinder. Oh, look at Luther. He's got a hold of the leg over here. Biggs grabs the foot on the Spellbinder. Here comes Stephen Dunn, and he puts his finger right in Biggs' face and says, keep your lousy hands off of the contestants in there.
Well, Billy Joe Travis right now working over the Spellbinder as a result of that interference.
We got all these other guys out here. This is ridiculous. This is a match between Spellbinder and Billy Travis, and I want those other three guys gone!
Voicing his displeasure over the fact that the Spellbinder has some real wrestling fans at ringside.
And Travis grabs the Spellbinder. Once again, across the ring, does the same thing as Billy Joe. Looks like he's suplexing, tried to. He just couldn't quite get him all the way up as the Spellbinder kicked himself right at the start. Down on the mat, Travis drops with an elbow, a cover arm. Oh, and that's right. He came close, but no cigar right there.
It's going to be a tough situation for Billy Joe Travis because he's giving away height and weight and giving away a lot of energy to the Spellbinder. The Spellbinder is fresh, but I got to think that Billy Joe Travis has expended a lot of energy on the fact that he was so upset over the fact he had to defend his title here on television. Look out, Lance. The big Doomsday has just entered the studio.
Well, you are right. Doomsday comes out into the studio area, and Luther Biggs is over talking to. Look at this lineup. Diamond, Flash Lanigan, and Dunn get between Doomsday and the ring. As Travis goes into the corner, he's got something wrapping around his head. It looks like a chain. Travis loosened it up on it as coming out.
Spellbinder's got his boot.
Yeah, he took his boot off. Hammers Travis. One, two, three. We have.
This is the biggest conspiracy in the history of professional wrestling. Billy Joe has been ripped off. Oh, Mr. St. John, you man, Russell, you won't stand for it.
He just lost it. The title goes to bridesmaid on many occasions, but he is the champion now, the Spellbinder.
And he took it in the ring. He beat him 1, 2, 3, and that's what counts.
We'll take time out and come back. Tell you more in a moment.
It's all here with cable TV. It's local news, sports, reliable service, and extra channels of your favorite premium services at no extra cost. 3 channels of HBO, 2 channels of Showtime, and 2 channels of Cinemax. Call now and have it all with this great offer. Save 50% off installation when you buy the Smart Choice package for $39.99 per month for 2 months. Save over $45. Call now for more premium channels and cable TV. It's all here.
The big news at Sonic this summer? We've got 5 everyday combo meals now. Extra long cheese conies, made-to-order burgers, chicken sandwiches, and they all come with large fries and a medium Coke.
Drive into Sonic this month and get a great deal on tickets to Opryland Theme Park. Receive $8 off adult or $3 off children's admission Sunday through Friday when you buy a Route 44 big drink filled with Coca-Cola.
Hi, I'm Suzanne DePriest, General Manager of All-Star Chevrolet Geo Polaris in Olive Branch, Mississippi. When my dad got me in this business, he started me out in sales, and the first thing he taught me was to listen to the customer's needs, then follow through with the right car at the best possible price. You see, at All-Star, we want repeat customers, and we want you to tell your friends about us. So if you're in the market for a new or used car or truck, come pay us a visit. We're located at Highway 78 and Craft Road, just 5 minutes from Memphis. I promise you'll like the way my family does business.
At the Happy Hawker, you'll find all kinds of merchandise at incredible savings. If you like to pay reasonable prices when you buy jewelry, diamonds, musical instruments, cameras, TVs, VCRs, tools, and guns. If you're the kind of person who really searches for just the right gift at just the right price, then you may make a great pawn shopper. Need cash? See us for the lowest rates on loans with the area's only drive-in loan department. Visit either Happy Hawker location, 975 East Parkway South, or our new superstore at 299 North Cleveland.
Earned it, but they have it. We're talking about $100 million of your money. And if you don't claim it, you can't get it. Stashed Cash, an Action News 5 investigation. Monday at 10 on Action News 5. They're doing God's work up on the roof, and they're doing it for free. This Sunday, meet teens from all over the country changing lives here in the Mid-South. Join Jaciel Cordova for People of Faith, Sunday at 10 on Action News 5. Coverage you can count on every day.
Inventories have reached their peak at your local Ford dealer, and there's only one person to save us now.
Okay, open it up.
It's time again for factory-authorized clearance.
Hey, guys, it's good to be back.
He's back, and he's clearing out the 97s and passing the savings on to you.
Well, that's my job.
Get $1,000 cash back or tune-on financing on Ranger. Save over $2,300 on the F-150 or $4,800 financing on Ford Explorer.
Wow, this is big!
So if you're looking to save a lot of cash,
then look for me!
During your local Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance.
USWA Wrestling is brought to you in part by Bill Blake Insurance, now with a new location at Getwell and Rhodes.
And they have changed it now? Already? Yeah. Okay, yeah, we'll get it. We'll get it. Michael changed this one right there to a title match on it. Talking about the action coming up 7:30 tomorrow night.
Big one.
And it is a big wrestling card. This is the biggest wrestling card in Memphis, Tennessee in years. Opening up the action, it'll be Steve Dunn against P.G. Walker. And then Paul Diamond will take on Bulldog Reigns. And as we just got in our ears, it was just changed, we understand. The USWA Heavyweight Championship will be on the line in this match, as the Spellbinder will put the belt that he just won here on television today up against Big Doomsday tomorrow night at 7:30 at the Big One. Plus, the Survivor match, 2 out of 3 falls, no disqualification, no time limit. There must be a winner. The loser will be handcuffed to the turnbuckle and receive 10 lashes. Brian Christopher against Billy Joe Travis, and there will be a lot of bad blood settled right there in that
match. Yeah, there will be no title on the line because Travis doesn't have the title. The title will take place in the Doomsday's Spellbinder. Following that is going to be the Hardcore Showdown. That's going to be Mr. Monday Night, Rob Van Dam and Sabu going against Chris Candido and Taz.
The USWA tag team titles will be on the line. ECW, they're being pinned as ECW's tag team. J.C. Ice and Wolfie D, they're known as PG-13. They'll take on Flash Flanagan and Nick Densmore. Plus, the big battle of Memphis Stampede Royal Rumble. Two men start out in the ring, and then another man enters the ring in one-minute intervals until you've got it. Well, there'll be at least 16, maybe more, because names are still coming in to be in this big Stampede Royal Rumble there at the Big One tomorrow evening at 7:30.
Every match is high voltage, and then it's capped off by that main event.
The brawl to end it all, ECW versus USWA. They're invading the USWA's home territory. Jerry the King Lawler and Brian Christopher tagging together for the USWA to take on the ECW's Tommy Dreamer. He's a real maniac in the Sandman, and we've already heard about him.
Yeah, we heard from him. We heard what the King had to say and Brian Christopher. So that is just exactly what they say, the brawl to end it all. Okay, that match in there that's going to have the hardcore showdown with Rob Van Dam and Sabu going against Chris Candido and Taz. We've got some comments coming out of Taz. Let's hear what he had to say about it.
Tomorrow night, Memphis, a new era begins. We're coming to town. You see, I heard they just did one of them nitros in Memphis. That's great. You know, you're here in Memphis here, you got this this USWU, USWE.
USWA.
Yeah. Yeah. If I want you to talk, I'll beat it out. You shut your hole until I tell you to talk. Memphis promotion, USWA. Right. Great. You see, we're ECW, we're just a little bit different. You know, when you hear ECW, you think about, you know, chairs and baseball bats and barbed wire and tables and garbage cans. That's great. All those weapons are great. And I'm sure Dreamer and Sandman, along with Sabu and Van Dam, they'll give you those weapons. But you see, me, I'm a little different. See, I'm Taz. I'm the human suplex machine. And I don't need a weapon. Because my hands are my weapons. I will, and I guarantee you, I will wrap my hands around someone's neck and choke them out with the Taz mission, the Kata Hajime. That is a violent act. I will commit a violent act by robbing someone of their oxygen. A violent act committed by a violent man. Me, Taz, the world television champion. Things are going to be a little different in Memphis tomorrow night. It's going to go back to the way it used to be in Memphis. Pure wrestling from me, Taz. Pure violence from me, Taz. Pure ability from me, Taz. Pure excitement, pure mayhem, pure rage from the path of rage. So I'll tell you what, you show up at the Big One Expo Center and experience something besides ECW. Me, the human suplex machine, the world television champion. Beat me if you can. Survive if I let you.
Tomorrow night, 7:30 at the Big One, the brawl to end it all. Wait a minute. Oh, I wasn't expecting this.
Ridiculous. So this is how the game is played. You put four men out here. The USWA puts four men out here on the champion. A big muscle-headed idiot clubs him in the head with the boot, and he loses the belt. Well, Michael St. John.
Shut up. Now let me tell you something. This is Redemption Day. Tomorrow night at the Big One. I sat back there and I thought about what happened. You know who called this? Brian Christopher. Well, let me tell you something, Brian. Tomorrow night, do you see this bell? I'm going to beat you so bad your mama's going to feel it, your daddy too. Tomorrow night, Billy Joe is going to beat you. And after that, I'm going to win the Battle Royal. I'm going to be a man. I'm going to be the champion again.
All right, there. Billy Joe Travis obviously quite upset. The Big One tomorrow night. The USWA all over the area. Let's get what's going on throughout the territory of the USWA.
All right, thanks a lot, Michael. I am getting excited just thinking about tomorrow night, 7:30 p.m. at the Big One Expo Center. Cannot wait for that action. Can't wait for some of the other action coming up around USWA on tour. Let's take a look at it. Tomorrow afternoon, we're going to be in Caruthersville, Missouri at 1:30 p.m. at the American Legion Field for a very special fundraiser when Lawler's Army softball team takes on the Caruthersville All-Stars. That's tomorrow afternoon at the American Legion Field, 1:30 p.m. in Caruthersville, Missouri, and it's a great fundraiser. All the proceeds go to renovate the Pemiscot Hospital Pediatric Hall. So make sure you're there tomorrow afternoon in Caruthersville, 1:30. Wednesday night, July the 16th, 8 p.m., we return to Lula, Mississippi's Lady Luck Casino. That's this Wednesday night. Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, Jerry Lawler, PG-13, Wednesday night, the 16th, 8 p.m. at the Lady Luck Casino. Thursday night, we're going to be in Caruthersville, Missouri, July 17th, 7:30 p.m. at Casino Astar. Make sure you're down there if you're in the Caruthersville area. Look at the names on this one, a free autograph session, free color pictures of the king to the first 100 people in the door. Thursday night, July the 17th, 7:30 in Caruthersville. Then from there, Friday night, July 18th, Huntington, Tennessee, at the Civic Center, 8 p.m., hot USWA action. Billy Travis has an audition and a 10-man battle royal. Huntington, Tennessee, Friday night, July the 18th, 8 p.m. Memphis, Tennessee, next Saturday afternoon, July the 19th. We're going to be at Bluff City Autoplex at 12:30 in the afternoon. USWA goes in overdrive when the king hits the ring. Saturday afternoon, July the 19th, 12:30 p.m. at the Bluff City Autoplex. Then from there, Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday night, July the 25th, 8 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. More on that one next week. And rounding out the on-tour, Jonesboro, Arkansas, Saturday night, July the 26th, 8 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. The USWA on tour. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, like seeing the action live. Right now, Lance Russell, Michael St. John.
Yeah, we got something coming up here, Tony, you'll be interested in, too. I think all the folks will. They remember Paul E. Dangerously. Yeah, you remember him. Let's take a listen. We've got some words from ECW's guru.
And day out, the phone calls come in to the offices of Extreme Championship Wrestling from all the fans in the great wrestling town of Memphis, Tennessee. Please save this decrepit city state of professional wrestling. Jerry Lawler has sold his soul to the WWF and sold Memphis Wrestling right down the drain along with him. But I told you people that 10 years ago. I told you what a scumbag Jerry Lawler was. He was then, and he's even a bigger scumbag now. We understand at ECW. See, 4 years ago, the group of people that stand with me today took the city of Philadelphia by storm, took a town that was burned to the ground by the two big wrestling promotions, and they forgot where they came from. At ECW, we never forget where we come from. At Memphis, Tennessee, we know what you want. Extreme, hardcore, professional wrestling at its very best. And on a personal note, we're coming here to show up the king. We're coming here to show up the entire USWA. PG-13 can tell you all about that. We are here to show up the king because Jerry Lawler, on a personal note, I swear to God, I hate your filthy, stinking guts, and it's gonna be my pleasure for the wrestlers of Extreme Championship Wrestling to show you up in your hometown tomorrow night at the Big One Expo Center. A whole new era in Memphis wrestling begins. Because if you get to check out ECW, it goes like this. If you're not a fan of professional wrestling, you will become one. And if you are, we're gonna blow your socks off tomorrow night at the Big One Expo Center when we take you to the extreme.
Hey, wrestling fans, Paul Diamond here. Don't you dare reach for that remote. More great wrestling action coming right after this.
To be honest, I wasn't exactly the valedictorian of Mrs. Moxley's second grade class. So I was a bit surprised when she invited me back for career day.
Hi, kids. My name's Tyler, and I work for Bell South.
Do you drive the truck?
Pardon?
The truck that lifts the men up in the air.
No. Oh, no, no. I don't drive the truck. What I do is I try and help people get the telecommunication services they need by, say, hooking them up to the internet. Yes.
You know the guy that drives the truck?
Yeah. Well, there isn't just one guy, actually, but the truck is fun. But has anybody ever been involved in a video conference? Because those are neat. You get to, there's people talking back and forth. You know what? I drive the truck. Yes, I do. You know, I take you for a ride in the thing, but... Sorry.
Right now is the best time of the summer to save on menswear. At S&K Summer Clearance Sale, you'll find thousands of handsome suits starting at two for $199.90. And during this once-a-year summer clearance, all summer silk sport coats and sportswear are 20 to 33% off S&K's already low prices. Summer's just heating up, and at S&K, prices are coming down.
I see.
So where are you going to buy your next suit?
Shop the grand opening of our new superstore at the Commons, across from Wolf Chase Galleria.
It's home cover-up time at Curlow Construction, and it's your chance to uncover big savings on the improvements your home needs. Right now, save up to $300 on Curlow's best 20-year asphalt fiberglass shingle roof. Save up to $800 on low-maintenance weather-beating siding. Call this number right now for a free, no-obligation home improvement estimate. And with 100% bank rate financing and no money down, Curlow has you covered. Take advantage of home cover-up specials from Curlow Construction, Memphis' number one home improvement company.
Back on Championship Wrestling, coming your way with more action scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing already in the ring area, wrestling out of Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 277 pounds, the V-Man. His opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area, wrestling out of Thunder Bay, Ontario, Canada, weighing 239 pounds, Paul Diamond. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
We're ready for this one to get underway, the V-Man against Paul Diamond. Be quite a contest. Steve Dunn making his way over the table. He came out along with Paul Diamond. And Steve, good to have you out. We had Paul out a little bit earlier, and hopefully what we heard is a rumor of a little conflict between you and Paul is all over.
Yeah, you know how it is, Michael. Boys will be boys. Everything's squared away. Wasn't any big deal. We like to blow things out of proportion. You know, me and Paul been getting along just fine. Everything's great. Still ready to go after these tags. Tough opponent out there right now. I don't know a lot about this guy, but I'll tell you what, he's one big, strong individual.
He comes highly recommended into the USWA. Picked up Paul for the body slam, and the V-Man is going to drop an elbow and brightly Paul right out of the way.
Got to be a little bit quicker than that. I'll tell you what, this USWA is on fire. Paul Diamond's on fire. He's dropping the big hand. Big man with some big left hands.
Paul's just not taking any no matter out of this guy. He's just going right to the fight, using the fist and pounding the man down, wearing him out very quickly. He's going to throw him into the ropes across the way, and there's that spinning super kick.
I tell you what, that'll ring your bell. Come on, Paul.
Paul Diamond, Steve Dunn, obviously working out whatever rumor difficulties that there were.
Next week.
There it is, Diamond on the V-Man with the Russian leg sweep. And the V-Man is worse for wear right now. Paul Diamond with things going his way. And I got to tell you, against a new opponent, he did the right thing. He took the fight right to the main official.
That's what you got to do out there. You know, all the competitors here in the USW are double tough. Paul's a ring veteran. He knows what he's going to do and what he's going to do to get the job done. Oh, another spinning kick.
Caught him in the corner that time.
Yeah, he's going to get up from that one. Why don't they try?
Diamond just working him over big time. Paul backing him back into the corner again. Gonna toss him around, across the way. We are running out of time. We're gonna have to go to a break here in just a moment. And Paul is just continuing to work his opponent. We're gonna go ahead and take the break. And if we miss the outcome of this match, there it is, the Flying Bulldog. This could be it. One, two, three. That's it. We gotta take a break, and we'll be right back with more USWA action right after this message.
There's what I you think of ECW EC? Right there. You understand that?
Inventories have reached their peak at your local Ford dealer, and there's only one person to save us now.
Okay, open it up.
It's time again for factory-authorized clearance.
Hey, guys, it's good to be back.
He's back, and he's clearing out the 97s and passing the savings on to you.
Well, that's my job.
Get $1,000 cash back or tune-out financing on Ranger. Save over $2,300 on the F-150 or 4A financing on Ford Explorer.
Wow, this is big!
So if you're looking to save a lot of cash,
then look for me!
You're in your local Ford dealer's factory-authorized clearance.
For those who go the distance, the start is critical. That's why Exxon Superflow races to protect vital engine parts at the start when significant damage can occur. Superflow has a unique formula offering protection that's fast, protection that lasts.
Expecting? Me? Just look at him lying there after what he did to you. Wake Romeo up. I think it's time for a craving. Because there's nothing like the taste of my beef when it gets together with my steamy bun, my onions, and my pickle. I know how your type goes for pickles. Oh, no. You wouldn't dare.
Listen to the crystal.
You know, I've been in Memphis a long time. Bill Blake Insurance has, too. If you have never checked out the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance, then you're missing a Memphis tradition. Respect, service, and good value is part of doing business at Bill Blake Insurance.
Buying car insurance can be confusing, but not at Bill Blake Insurance. They can answer all your questions, and you only make one payment per month.
I sing the blues all over the world, but I always come home, and I always see the hometown boys at Bill Blake Insurance. At Bill Blake Insurance, he's from Memphis.
Because you love them, you want to leave behind fond memories, not bills. Because you love them, you want to spare your family the burden of your final expenses. Because you love them, you want to make things easier for those you leave behind. And that's what the burial expense plan from Physicians Life Insurance Company is all about. It provides your loved ones with up to $10,000 in their time of need. Cash to help settle your funeral, burial, and other final expenses. Just call this toll-free number to get your free information kit with all the details. If you're age 45 to 79, your acceptance is guaranteed. You won't have to take a physical exam or answer a single health question. And because this is permanent protection, you'll never have to worry about losing your coverage. It's modified whole life insurance that can be yours for the rest of your life. Think about it. All of us someday will leave behind final expenses for our loved ones to pay. There's no escaping it. Those burial costs and last medical bills can easily add up to thousands of dollars. Social Security pays a death benefit of just $255, and only if you qualify. Your loved ones will have to come up with the rest. That's why thousands of people across the country have turned to the burial expense plan. It's one sure and affordable way you can leave dollars instead of debts. It's exactly the kind of security you'd expect from Physicians Life, a leader in providing solid, affordable life insurance you can depend on. So if you're 45 to 79, call this number to get your free information kit directly by mail. There's no cost and no obligation. Because you love them, make the call now. Physicians Life. We're here when you need us.
Okay, in the ring. Wow, oh, that's Brian Christopher. You recognize him. Jerry the King Lawler. They're going against Keith Robertson and Buster Johnson, Michael. And look at them go. Think they weren't sitting on ready?
I tell you, they were loaded for bear on this one. And Brian Christopher just jumped in the ring from behind Keith Robertson. And both men, actually all four men in the ring right now. And the King nailing Robertson with that right hand. Buster Johnson being sent. And he gets caught with a big right hand of Brian Christopher. And Jerry the King Lawler and Brian Christopher, I'm sure that they have their mindset on those goons from ECW, but they're definitely taking the battle to these fellas right now in the ring here today.
Yeah, the King was just practicing his chokehold as he had a hold of Robertson, choking away on him. He was practicing that one up. I think he wants to use that for Tommy Dreamer when he comes rolling around. Buster Johnson just had his head rattled off of the top turnbuckle. It's Brian Christopher. Look at him over there, Michael, with Robertson.
And Jerry the King Lawler screaming out, this one's for Tommy Dreamer, and he's just pounding away. I tell you, we're running out of time on this match, Lance, and right now Lawler and Christopher are just beating the waylay out of these two guys.
Our time is just about gone. We hope you've enjoyed it. It's been really exciting. A new USWA. He got the victory. Brian Christopher, Vince Robertson. For Michael St. John, Lance Russell said, hey, don't you miss the opportunity tomorrow night. See you next week. Until then, bye-bye, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, including the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.
Clay Espy likes to put in a full day at work.
And then a full night.
Listen, Clay, I really need to get some air.
Open a window.
No, I just need to clear my head.
Can't you just jog around the conference table?
No, I'd really rather just go
deep
outside.
Deep knee bends always.
Clay! Sorry.
So when a workaholic like Clay wanted another phone line, he needed Bell South Saturday service.
Hey, good, you got my page.
Come here.
That and maybe a hobby.
I want to go over these numbers we were working on the other day.
The big news at Sonic this summer? We've got 5 everyday combo meals now. Extra long cheese conies, made-to-order burgers, chicken sandwiches, and they all come with large fries and a medium Coke.
Drive into Sonic this month and get a great deal on tickets to Opryland Theme Park. Receive $8 off adult or $3 off children's admission Sunday through Friday when you buy a Route 44 big drink filled with Coca-Cola.
Makes music? Find out at the Pink Palace Museum.
Harold Grader hosts Sports Sunday, Sunday at 10:30 on Action News.
This time on Motor Week, a Mercedes for the mud, a slick new Volvo, and a classy new venue for classy old cars. So come drive with us next.
Motor Week, television's original automotive magazine. Motor Week is brought to you by Mobil Oil. At Mobil, we've been changing oil for over 125 years. Your host for Motor Week, John Davis.
Well, hello and welcome again to Motor Week. We're glad to have you with us. The last few years have seen big changes at Volvo. Engines and chassis have become more powerful and more entertaining, while styling has become less like a cereal box. But while this has increased Volvo's enthusiast appeal, many drivers still can't get past that proper family sedan image. So Volvo has taken the next big step, this C70 coupe. Now, wouldn't you trade in your BMW for a Volvo like this? You would, only if you don't mind adding a dose of individuality and elegance to your driving experience. For the new Volvo C70 Coupe is both, but it refuses to be crass about either. Even in this stunning saffron clear coat, the car seemed amazingly at home among the sleepy streets of the graceful lady known as Savannah. This historic city's charm wraps around every corner. Yet the steamy beauty of the C70 glided past the timeless background without causing a visual stir. Framing the front style of the C70 are soft curves, a smallish grille, and complex lens headlights that, while clearly contemporary, just as clearly still say Volvo. C70 designers have managed to eliminate the box while retaining the lineage. It is an athletic shape from front to back, with just enough flare to the hips to keep things interesting. And at the rear, where the seemingly chopped roofline meets easily with a short trunk lid, the C70 is one car whose designers knew how to bring a flowing form to a tidy end. It is simply beautiful. The C70 project is a collaboration between Volvo and Tom Walkinshaw Racing, which